Hi there. Welcome in. Here's a thought. The perfect expression of receiving a lifetime award is to be working when they're handing it out. That's from Broadway's Hal Prince. And guess what? I am still working with brand new Sleep Stories podcast that begins and is launched this Monday. But I'll tell you about that then. This is a totally different kind of journal today, and not just because I'm all dressed up, because yesterday something happened. Well, it sort of happened, and it was 40 years in the making. Yes, I was 18 when I got my first radio job, and that girl then had no inkling that this could ever be a possibility. A Hall of Fame for broadcasters in Canada? But it is. And as of yesterday, a year later than announced and done virtually, I'm in. Rather than lament not being able to have a large gathering and celebration of all kinds of friends in the industry I loved so much, I'm going to focus on the positive and share it with you, the person who made it possible. First, I'm going to play you the introduction and very kind words from people extremely dear to me that ushered me in, and then my very brief response. And when you see me holding the award for the very first time, that is absolutely real, as I got ready, and then we waited and waited for the FedEx truck to arrive on Monday night so that I could shoot a video and send this response for yesterday's show. Are you following me here? Oh, it was sad just waiting for the doorbell to ring. It was like every Saturday night in my teens. But anyway, we've come a long way, so here we go.
It is my absolute honor to pay tribute to the newest inductee into the Canadian Music Broadcast Industry Hall of Fame, Erin Davis. Wicked smart, hilarious, hardworking, fearless, and a total trailblazer, Erin, you are the gold standard in our business. There are so many things that I admire about you, Erin, but I'm going to call out two. First of all, no matter how successful you are, and you've always been number one with a bullet, you are always so nice to everyone. Second, whether it was radio, TV, blogging before it was cool, from social to podcasting, Erin, you happily went wherever the community was. Thank you, Erin, for everything you've done for our business. Working with you has been one of the absolute highlights of my career. Congratulations on your induction into the Hall of Fame.
CHFI is Toronto's most listened to radio station because we play the most music.
We're the office favorite with 98 minutes of music commercial free.
Mm-hmm. Whoa, ho, 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 ho. Commercial free?
That's right, yeah.
Aren't you?
Yeah, the new sales manager. Look, ixnay on the commercial free thing. No money in it. No, do re mi. I have got a plan.
Erin is not just a magnificent, fabulously talented broadcaster, but she's a fantastically wonderful human being. And it has been my pleasure and my privilege to call her my friend.
Erin has always been a gift to broadcasting. Her charm, her wit, her eloquence, her intelligence has always put her just slightly above the rest.
Erin Davis's name was practically synonymous with Toronto's CHFI for decades. This Edmonton-born broadcaster had been a morning show fixture dating back to 1988.
It's a tough gig, day in, day out, early mornings, all that stuff. But Erin has that rare showbiz quality that separates her from the majority of the pack. She sincerely, honestly cares.
I'm not biased at all, of course, but I think Erin is one of the kindest, most caring, and genuine people in Canadian broadcasting, and I'm just so pleased that she's being honored in this way.
She is an iconic broadcaster and opened a lot of doors for women.
Her trailblazing path as a female broadcaster was recognized in 2009 with a Rosalie Award. And she's been honored by many organizations for her public service and charitable work.
She's always had this deep passion for compassion and honesty to a fault. And her legions of fans love her to death. And quite frankly, so do I.
Her respect for her guests and her audience is legendary. And not once have I ever sensed a false sincerity coming from Erin, which must be a show business record.
This isn't goodbye. It's just a change of address. and a thank you note 28 years in the writing. Thank you.
Erin hung up her headphones in 2016, a year after the unexpected death of her daughter. She funneled her grief into writing a book, Mourning Has Broken, Love, Loss, and Reclaiming Joy, which landed on the top 10 bestseller list for nonfiction.
Her book, Mourning Has Broken, is really special. Erin has been a testament to the human spirit, to strength and grace.
For 25 years, I sat alongside you and basically just paid attention. You taught us what it meant to show up and shine every day, and you made us better broadcasters.
Erin now lives on Vancouver Island with her husband, Rob.
Congratulations, sweetie.
Nobody deserves it more.
Congratulations to one of the great dames of broadcasting.
Erin, a heartfelt, well-deserved congratulations.
You'll always be the greatest. I love you. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Erin. This honor is truly deserved. I love you. If we can solve any problem,
then why do we lose so many tears?
Oh, thank you. To the Canadian Music and Broadcast Industry Hall of Fame, my deepest gratitude for this honor. Julie, Valerie, Mike and Ian, Jan and Rick and Rudy, your words mean so much because you do, and I'll thank you personally, I promise. Wow. Thank you to radio for everything in my life. Even my beloved husband, Rob, met through radio. Therefore, our Lauren and her son, radio. To my friends at Rogers for the life that we have on this beautiful West Coast. But most of all, I will be forever grateful for that magical radio connection, that one-to-one. It made me, it saved me, and it will carry me always. Thank you. Well, as you can see, the award didn't show up and I had a deadline, so my thank you was without the award, but I promise I'll share it with you when I get it because I want to see it too. Anyway, thank you for sharing in this moment with me, and I meant everything I said about the one-to-one because it's still here, this connection, and it's with you. Thank you.